I've done it both ways. And I, for years, I believed in doing it without a roadmap or any idea of what was going to happen. And many times I've sat down and just started writing with no idea what was going to pop up. And through that process, I found the characters and the story. And I think writing is really fun when you get up in the morning and you go back to the machine because you want to know what happens next, but you don't have any idea what that's going to be. So I think wonderful novels can be born from that method. There's nothing wrong with that method. That is a wonderful way because your subconscious and your conscious are both organizing that material for you. And as long as you are moving forward with a fine sense of what feels authentic and what doesn't, I think it's a fine way to write a novel. I certainly wrote Interview with the Vampire that way. I didn't have any idea what was going to happen from moment to moment. I just knew that I wanted to interview a vampire, get him to tell me everything that he knew as an immortal and as a predator and as a monster and as a person who'd once been human. And I really didn't know who was going to pop up or what was going to happen. And suddenly, when I started to look through this character's eyes, I felt this like tremendous rush of energy and capacity for writing about questions and things that had mattered to me passionately that I'd never been able to get close to when trying to write pedestrian realism. I'd just never been able to get there. And I was off and running, and other characters were born, characters I never foresaw. Lestat, Claudia, Armand, all of these different characters, all of this was a matter of surprises. Now, as time went on, I did develop better notions of what I wanted to accomplish in a novel, but not always. And even when I developed the ability to completely outline a book, you know, to say, well, I want to create this character and this dilemma, and I see this story, and this is going to happen, and that's going to happen, even when I could completely outline, that outline was something that I never really looked at again once I started writing, or very rarely did I turn to it. I outlined that stuff from my own mind. And once I started writing, what was exciting were the surprises, the things I hadn't foreseen, the character who suddenly popped up and took over, you know, or got in a dialogue with the main character and just completely surprised me by the things that came out. This happens in every book, and I think it's a wonderful and exciting thing. So I think your question is important because inevitably, whether you start with a roadmap, whether you start with a whole detailed idea, whether you start with nothing, you're basically doing the same thing. You're putting everything you know into this story, and you're feeling, you're groping for what feels authentic. You have to be ready, I think, to take 30 pages if necessary and throw them away if you take a wrong turn in the novel. And you have to go back to where it last felt really good and go on from there. And for some people, this might be a very sloppy way of working, but for me, it's really the only way. And I really love working that way. I wouldn't hesitate tomorrow if I didn't have, you know, a novel already churning away in my mind. If I drew a blank or wanted to move away, I wouldn't hesitate at all to start with the blank screen and just go and just see what would come up. I think we're fully entitled to do that, and we should do that. That's a good question. Thank you.